Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Divisha Agrawal and I make videos about fashion, travel, lifestyle and beauty. So today is not a vlog day, but it's a Monday and I'm going to be shooting a few reels, and I thought that maybe today is the day that I show you guys the whole process and everything related to reels that I personally follow, and that actually changed my entire social media game. And my Instagram and YouTube audience is growing day by day, as you guys know, and I think reels and shorts play a very, very important role in that. So I'm going to be sharing everything step by step that I follow when it comes to making reels and short videos. It's a lot of actually effort and procedure, like it's a long process. So stay tuned and watch till the end, because it's gonna be super informative, super chill and a little fun as well. So let's get started with the video. So I have my diary with me, wherein I have written down all the points that I actually personally follow with respect to making reels, and I actually swear by these points whenever I have to plan a reel or a short video, because short form content is the future and we have to excel at it. So the first point is ideating and inspiration. Now ideation is the most important point because of obvious reasons. If your idea is creative enough and it's a great idea, it's unique and it makes you, you know, stand out from all the crowd, then the viewers are going to eventually find you and they are gonna stay. So it's a really attractive point when someone works on their own unique idea rather than just copy pasting content. So you can always take inspiration from a creator, but you know, completely stealing their idea is it's not acceptable. And even if you are taking inspiration from a creator, then I think it's very, very important to give them their due credits, because it's only ethical. So inspiration can come from absolutely anywhere. Sometimes it's actually weird that sometimes I just listen to a piece of music and I feel like, okay, this is it, I have to shoot this particular thing on this particular music in this particular way. So that's how a creator mind works. And sometimes I get inspired from all the trends that are trending on Instagram, YouTube, so that's always good. And apart from that, I make sure that my reels are either value-adding, either entertaining, or is very, very informative, and it's not just a time pass, you know, thing, because that's just not my taste and I don't consume that kind of content myself. So I make sure to at least include one of these points in my videos always. So that's that. And I always make sure that I am making most of my reels and short videos based on fashion, because that's my main niche. So you can pick your niche and you can stick to it like throughout, and make sure that you are making consistently videos based on that particular niche, because that's gonna drive the kind of audience that you actually want and that actually resonates with you and your page. So that's a great point. So basically work on your ideas, take inspiration from anywhere, anytime, and you know, while maybe watching a movie, TV show, or even just sitting, you know, not doing anything, brainstorming, it works like magic. Now the second point is selecting outfits. Since you all know that my main niche is fashion and I make fashion related videos more than anything else, so I am very particular about what outfits I'm going to pick, because that's the first impression that you are, you know, creating on a new viewer. So you want to be impressive and you want to add your personal touch to it, and you have to put your best foot forward and you have to represent your best style in that particular, like, you know, in the span of what, 2-3 seconds. So it's really, really important to work on your outfits thoroughly, like from makeup to accessories to shoes to bags and basically the whole, you know, silhouette. So it's really, really important. So never ignore that, and don't just make reels for time pass if you want to actually grow your channel or your Instagram. So I would suggest that always pre-plan your stuff in advance. Like if today I have to shoot a few reels, then I have already pre-planned all of my content and outfits and accessories and everything in advance. So that way it makes this process so much more smoother and hassle-free. So who doesn't like that? So the third point is arranging outfits and setting up your equipment. Now for me, organizing plays a very, very important role, because if all my stuff is organized, then my shoot is like, you know, super, super smooth, and I don't have to really worry about my outfits and ironing them or things like that. So if it's pre-planned, it's always great. And at the time of shoot, you're just focusing on your camera and just enjoying yourself and, you know, giving out all those energetic vibes and everything, because it's really, really important and significant when it comes to short form content. Now, arranging outfits. By that I mean, if let's say if I'm planning to shoot reels in 3 to 4 outfits, then I'll make sure that all my outfits are ironed properly, and I stack them on my bed usually and put matching accessories and shoes and bags and basically everything that would go with that particular outfit. So while shooting, I just have to pick one thing and wear it and just showcase. So it becomes very, very smooth that way. And for the equipment, now I usually prefer shooting on my phone when it comes to reels and everything, because it's really easy to, you know, just edit it and post it right away. But you can use a camera as well, you can use anything that you are comfortable with, but phone I would definitely suggest. Another thing that I've learned from my own journey is lighting is very important. Now, I used to shoot in very dim and dull light before, but because I did not have enough resources, but now I've invested in a rig light and sort of everything. But if you don't have an external light source, then please try and always shoot in daylight, because that's the best light source you can get, and that always works like, you know, perfectly. So if you have a ring light, please make sure that you always put it on while shooting your short form content, because it's gonna enhance your quality. And yeah, so that's about the equipment and outfits. Now the fourth point is actually not really important, but actually very significant, because you have to look a little presentable while you are in front of the camera and facing a much larger audience than what you already have, right? So you know, doing a little bit of makeup and enhancing your features, it always works the best. So I'm gonna go and do that, and I'll see you after that. So I'm all set for the reels, and I've done a little bit of makeup. Let me show it to you. So I have applied a little bit of concealer under my eye and a little bit of eyeliner on the edges, because I like it that way, and blush, because that's important, mascara, and a little hint of lipstick on my lips. You can do whatever makeup that suits you and whatever that you are comfortable with. I'm comfortable with this minimal look always, so I've done this, and now we are going to do the next step, which is actually shooting the reel. So for shooting, I am going to show my setup to you guys, which is okay. So this is my usual setup. I put my ring light on the back of my phone, and I usually shoot in my front camera so that I can see myself. It helps with so many things, and yeah, I'm using this tripod and the ring light. I'll link everything in the description box if in case you want to check it out. And that's it, that's my fancy setup. Okay, so that was my setup. Now I have to clear this space out, because usually I shoot my reels against this wall, so I'll have to move my furniture a little bit to make space for me. So I'm gonna do that. Okay, so that is it, and now I have this wall in front of me to shoot all of my great reels.
Okay, so now I'm going to be taking the first shot of my reel, which is basically to display the title of my reel, and that is, by the way, styling a shirt in very basic, relatable, wearable ways, because I get this a lot, that whatever that you show in your videos, it's not really relatable or wearable outside. So I'm gonna show that to you, that you can actually use in your day-to-day life, and it's gonna be really helpful as well as informative. So let's do that.
All set.
Oh,
Also, always make sure that the first 2-3 seconds of your reels is really, really catchy, and you can play with multiple texts and fonts and colors and all of those things. Wow. So you can do that. And also, while framing, while setting the frame, always make sure to leave extra space for your text that you are going to add later on, because it always helps while editing. So do that, and always set the frame in such a way that it captures your entire outfit, your shoes as well as your hair, and it's not like, you know, basically cutting anything off, like, out of the frame. So that's one thing that's very basic, and you should keep that in mind. So now I'm gonna go and change, and we're gonna shoot the rest of the reel then. Okay, so I am all ready now, and I'm going to style this particular shirt in 3 different ways, and I'm going to be shooting the transitions as well. So I think I'm gonna need 2 transitions. So one, I'm gonna do the punch thing, and the second maybe a simple snap or a clap or something like that. So we'll figure that out. Also, one more important point is to always take multiple shots while you are doing the transitions, because it's really important to see, like, you know, sometimes something might not look good or something might not fit while editing. So you should always have multiple shots with you so that you always have options. So it's always great. Also, another thing to keep in mind is marking your positions while you know, doing transitions, because I have seen people do transitions that are not very smooth, because they tend to change their positions before and after the transition, and doesn't look you know, flawless or anything. For that, you can use one thing that is like transparent tape or something, and you can mark it on the floor, like, you know, marking your position before and after the transition, so that you start and end your shot from that particular positions only. So I have never tried this myself, because I always use you know, these lines on my floor to mark my position, which is very jugadu. But you can actually use a tape. Another thing that I've recently started doing is playing some sort of music in the background while I'm shooting the reels, because that really changes the whole vibe, and you start vibing to the music, and it just looks so much better in the camera, like you're just enjoying making the reels and la la la. So do that. It's a little tip, little hack that has worked really well for me personally. I'm gonna play some music and maybe, you know, vibe to it. So now I'm going to shoot. So taking the same position and doing the transition, it's really, really important from where I left the first shot. So okay, we got the shot, and I think that is it. Like, I'm just going to show you the process behind one reel only, because it will be else, you know, half an hour long video, and which I don't want. And yeah, I mean, that is everything that is there, but the most important part is still left, which is the editing bit. And I'm going to clean the mess in my room now, and after that I'm going to show you the editing process and how I edit and which app do I use to edit my reels and videos. And yeah, I'm gonna give you a little small tutorial for the same, so stay tuned and watch that, and then sign off from this video. So for editing, I use the InShot app. It is available on Play Store and App Store as well. I absolutely love it, because it's so user friendly, and you get the hang of it easily after editing a couple of videos. Now in this video, I am literally trimming the unnecessary extra footage and keeping the ones that that looks the best. Be precise and clear about how you want your video to look like. That would make the editing bit super simple. Now coming to transitions, as I said, we are going to do a punch and a snap transition. I'm going to show you how to edit the transition smoothly. In this case, I'm doing a snap transition. So here is what I do. I cut the first recorded clip at the point where my fingers are about to snap, somewhat midway of the snap. Now in the second half of this transition, I attach the second recorded clip. This time I cut that clip from the point I snap my fingers till the end of the clip. In entirety, I am just trimming 2 clips and attaching them to make the transition look super smooth and complete. It's not that easy to explain, but if you see carefully and practice, you can master it definitely. So that's all about editing.
Alright, so that's it for today's video. I really, really hope that you guys enjoyed it and you learned something really, really important points from it, and you'll pick it up and you'll excel at the content creation game. Share it with your content creator friends, and also if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to show some love in the comment section below, because I honestly love reading all your comments and replying to them. So yeah, and also if you want more videos like these, like based on content creation and tips and tricks and blah blah blah, so please let me know, and I'll make them, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.